I've made a copy of ODB12 dates and dollar signs and called this one ODB13 pattern field. I've opened up the form to show us that we're at the point we left off at the end of the last video. We're going to look at the phone number field in this video. Right now, I can type in anything I like into this field. Here I've got some letters, some numbers, and some special characters. I can save it, go to the next record, and when I go back, we see that those letters, numbers, and special characters are still in the number field. We want to change that so our form will only accept numbers in this field. To do that, we're going to go into edit mode. So I'm going to close this and reopen it in edit mode. What we're going to do is to remove our phone number text field and replace it with a pattern field. A pattern field will allow us to only accept numbers in the text box, at least for our case. There are times when you may want to have only letters, maybe for a name field, or only numbers and letters, but no special characters. We can do all that using a pattern field. So I'm going to hold down Control and click on the phone number text box and delete it. The pattern field is on the More Controls toolbar. So I'm going to have to come over to our More Controls icon on our Controls toolbar. The pattern toolbar is a little hand over a box. And I'll enter it onto our form. I'm going to right-click on my new text box and click on Control to open up the Properties dialog box. We're going to give our field a new name. We're going to call this PTN Phone Number. Going over to the Data tab, we want to select Phone Number. Going back to the General tab, we want to make this look like our other text boxes. So we're going to make the border 3D, give it a height of 0.25, and a background color of gray 10%. When we add a new field, it usually puts it to the bottom of our tab order. So I'm going to come down to our tab order or our activation order, click on that, select our phone number, and move that up just under our end date. For our new field, we want to put in something called an edit mask. An edit mask is just like a Halloween mask. It will hide certain parts and let other parts show through. Just like a Halloween mask hides part of the face, but allows another part of the face, like the eyes, to show through. In our pattern properties box, we want to go up to the top, and we see we've got two fields with mask. We've got an edit mask and a literal mask. Let's start with the literal mask. I'm going to put in some characters. I'm going to put in a left parenthesis, asterisk, 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 right parenthesis, space, underscore, 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 dash, underscore, 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 underscore. So that's how we want them to type in the numbers, where the underscores and the asterisks are. And I use two different characters to show you that they don't have to be all underscores, all asterisks. You can put in anything you like there. Now let's look at the edit mask. For this one, I'm going to put in L N N N L L N N N L N N N N. Let's take a look at this and see if we can figure it out before I bring up the key. Where I have the N's is where I want to allow the numbers. Here's the edit mask key. If it's an L, this position cannot be edited. It will use what is in the literal mask value. If it's a lowercase a, it can be lowercase or uppercase letter. If it's an uppercase a, characters A to Z, but they have to be capital. It will convert lowercase to capital. A lowercase c is characters and numbers. An uppercase c is characters and numbers, but the characters will be capitalized. N, this is what we're using, only numbers 0 through 9. And X is all printable characters, and a capital X is all printable characters, but letters will be capitalized. I'll put this key out on the website in case you want to download it. So we know what this is now. Let's see how it works. Let's go down to Edit View. And I need to click off all our objects. Let me close our More Controls toolbar. I'm going to put in a number. Let's put in 999. I'll try and put in some letters. It doesn't allow it. 5551234. Our parentheses have to be there. We have our space and our dash. All our other values have to be numbers. Let's go to the next record. What happens if I take them all out? We've got our asterisks and underscores. If I save this, go to the next record, when I come back, we still see the asterisks and the underscores. Let's see what this looks like on our table. This is record number 9. I'm going to come down to our data source as a table. We see record number 9. I'll need to scroll over to see the phone number. We see our edit mask. So what we put in that edit mask is going to be our default value. Let's close our data source. Go back into edit mode. So it's a little clearer now. Our edit mask tells us what can go in that field. It can only be 14 characters, because that's all that I put in here to our edit mask. The only values we can change are the n's. The l's have to be what is down in our literal mask in that position. So that's how our literal mask works. I'm going to close the properties dialog box. Save the form, close the form, and save our database.